Hello friends, GYS, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started MCQ series of different types of topics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, History, Polity, Geography, Economy, etc. So what we are doing in basically these series, we cover daily 5 questions of each topic and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So daily we cover 5 questions of each topic. As we are covering 6 topics, so you can multiply 5 with 6. Daily we cover 30 questions that are prelims, totally prelims oriented. So in this way you will be doing much practice. If you daily follow these series, then you can approximately go by calculation that by 31st May we will be covering 1000 questions of each topic, and this is a much needed practice which you must do before entering the exam hall. So let's start our discussion, friends. What is the lecture? What is the first question of today's lecture of Medieval India, lecture number 15? The first is, with reference to Khajuraho temples, consider the following statements. So we have to consider the statements with respect to Khajuraho temples. First is, they are made of sandstone. Second, both the interior and exterior walls are lavishly decorated with carvings. Third is, stelate plan style of temple making is followed. So friends, let me tell you that first statement is correct, that Khajuraho temples were made of sandstone. This is certainly correct. But regarding second statement, friends, both the interior and exterior walls are lavishly decorated. This is also correct, because if you see the Khajuraho temples in Madhya Pradesh, they are lavishly decorated, both from the internal walls and their external walls are also lavishly decorated. Regarding the third statement, the third statement is incorrect, friends, because they did not follow the stelate plan style of temple making. Actually, this pattern was followed in Hosala school of temple making, this stelate plan style. So it was not followed in Khajuraho temples. So only first and second statement is correct. So the A option is the correct option. So let's see the solution. So the solution is C, and the explanation is that Khajuraho temples were basically patronized by Chandela dynasty, and there are some of the important features of these, that they are the temples made of sandstone, and they both have interior and exterior walls that are lavishly decorated. Actually, the style of temple making which they followed was known as Panchayatan. The stelate pattern was followed by the Hosala school of art, and the temples were basically north or east facing, and they were on relatively high platforms. And examples of these temples are Lakshmana temple, Kendriya Mahadeva temple, and some Jain temples are also found in Khajuraho. So this is about your first question. Let's move on to second question. Second question is, with reference to Akbar's policy, consider the following statements. First is, in pursuance of his Rajput policy, Akbar abolished jizya and extended pilgrimage tax to Muslims also. Second statement is, Akbar not only inducted Rajput Rajas into Mughal administration but also treated them on par with Mughal officials. Third statement is, Akbar treated matrimonial alliances with Rajput Rajas as test of loyalty and submission. So regarding first statement, friends, let me tell you that Akbar did abolish the jizya, but he also abolished the pilgrim tax. There was no extending of the tax to Muslims. It was totally abolished. The jizya as well as pilgrimage tax was totally abolished. And regarding the second statement is correct. First statement is incorrect, but the second statement is correct in the terms that the Rajput Rajas, they treated the Rajput Rajas were treated in the Mughal administration at par with the Mughal officials. For example, Raja Man Singh or Raja Bhagwan Singh, they were the important officials in the Mughal court of Akbar. So second statement is correct. Regarding the third statement is incorrect, friends, because Akbar did not treated these matrimonial alliances as a test of loyalty or submission. Basically, they were alliances of convenience, also for Akbar and also for the Rajput Rajas, and they were appropriate for considering the conditions of time. So the answer is 1 and 3rd only. So only 2nd statement is correct. So the answer is 2nd only. So C answer is correct, that is 1st and 3rd statements are incorrect, as I have told you earlier. So the solution is C. So let's move on to the third question, friends, we provide the explanation of only first question so that you can get the idea that whether we are providing the explanation up to the level of UPSC or not. So you might have get the idea, that idea. If you want to get the further explanation of further questions, then you have to follow certain procedures, and then you will be subscribed to the explanation of all the questions, friends. So in this case we will now only cover solutions and the questions. Now let's move on to the third question. The third question is, with reference to the Bhagavatism, consider the following statements. First is, it supported animal sacrifices in line with Vedic culture. Second is, there was no place for tribal gods in Bhagavatism. So let me tell you, friends, that first is correct. First is incorrect. They did not supported animal sacrifices. Actually, they believed in the bhakti aspect. So they said that with devotion you can get salvation. Regarding second statement, friends, second statement is also incorrect. Both the statements are incorrect because tribal gods were assimilated in Bhagavatism. For example, the Narayana was a famous tribal god, and he was identified with Vishnu. So there was kind of integration of tribal gods with the Hindu gods. So the a process of kind of cultural homogenization was taking place at that time. So there was a place for tribal gods. So both the statements are incorrect. So the correct answer is D. That is neither one nor two. So let's move on to your fourth question. The fourth question is, with reference to Raj Tarangani, consider the following statements. Raj Tarangani, written by Kalhan, gives a historical account of various dynasties that ruled the regions in Ganga Basin. Second is, the book written in Sanskrit focuses only on praising various kings in glowing terms. So let me tell you, friends, that the first statement is incorrect. The Raj Tarangani was written by Kalhana, but it did not make the chronological order of Ganga Basin kings. The Kalhana had basically combined the chronological order of kings in Kashmir and not the Ganga Basin. So the first statement is incorrect. Regarding second statement, friends, second statement is also incorrect because he didn't only eulogize the kings. He also criticized some kings for their policies. So both these statements are incorrect. So the correct answer is D. That is neither one nor two. Regarding explanation, if you want the explanation, then you will have to subscribe to our explanation PDFs. Lastly, let's move on to the fifth question. Fifth question is, with reference to administration in Delhi Sultanate, consider the following pairs. So with reference to administration, we have to consider the departments and the work associated with that department. The first is Diwan-e-Insha. So religious matters, Diwan-e-Risalat, state correspondence, Diwan-e-Arz dealt with requirements of army. So let me tell you, friends, that the first and second statements are incorrect because actually the Diwan-e-Insha was for the state correspondence and not Diwan-e-Risalat. And Diwan-e-Risalat was responsible for religious matters and not for state correspondence matters. So both these are incorrectly matched. So only third is correctly matched. That is Diwan-e-Arz that dealt with the requirements of army. It is correctly matched. So the solution is C. So friends, this is all about your questions of today that we have included in the lecture series, MCQ series of environment and of medieval India. So friends, if you want the explanation PDFs, then you can WhatsApp us. I will tell you the complete procedure in few minutes. So friends, let me tell you first that why these explanation PDFs are important. They are basically, friends, at the end of the day you will not be able to see 20 to 25 minute long videos, and also at that time you will not have that much time that you read standard books or NCERTs again. They can be read only around one or two times. After that they become boring and they become monotonous. The revision becomes boring. Revision is the most boring part of preparation, but is the most important part of your preparation that decides your preparation. 70% role is played by the revision that you have done of the syllabus. So if you haven't consolidated the syllabus by revising it, that there is no purpose of reading. But reading from standard books at the time of exam, when your exam is near, also becomes boring, and also it creates tension in your mind. So it creates pressure in your mind. So for that purpose, the most accepted approach and the most followed approach is the question answer format. That is, seeing a question and then seeing its solution and then seeing why particular option is correct and why others are not correct. So that is the UPSC is not just about seeing the question and its answer. The UPSC is also about seeing a question and its answer and its explanation. So you can get the idea that why a particular option has been given the correct status and why others are incorrect, so that you can revise comprehensively. So in this manner, you can revise in a very short time because you read a question and you read it with curiosity and then you move on for your answer part, and if your answer is wrong, then you go for your explanation part. So in this way, revision takes place effectively, and you feel confident in the exam hall. So if you want to subscribe to them, then there is a nominal procedure. I will let you know about it. So let's see what is the procedure. So friends, this is the procedure, friend. Basically, you have to do WhatsApp at our number. So this is our number 8968 4284 6481, 8968 4284 6481. So this is our number. So basically, we are charging different amount for different series. So friends, this is the cost respectively. For environment it is 50, for ancient India it is 100, for medieval it is 100, for modern also it is 100, and for geography it is 400, and for polity it is 200. So friends, let me tell you that it is not the cost of one PDF. It is the cost of entire PDFs that you will get till 31st May. That is, you will get all the PDFs that we have covered and all the PDFs that we will be covering till 31st May. It is a single time payment. There is no repeated payment for each PDF. So for example, if you are subscribing for Medieval India, so you have to just pay rupees 100 and then forget. Then you have to keep in mind only one thing, that you have to get the PDF from our side till 31st May, 31st May on daily basis. So this is the approach. And friends, this is also friends, also this is not just 1,000 questions that we are giving you. For example, if you go by calculation, then approximately by 31st May we would have covered approximately 1,000 questions. So these are not just 1,000 questions that you will be receiving from our side. You will be receiving 4,000 concepts. How, friends, it becomes 4,000? Because in each question you will see its answer. It's you will see why a particular answer is correct and why other options are not correct. So in this way, you cover four concepts in each topic. So if you want to subscribe to these PDFs so that you can revise quickly and in an effective manner, so with the minimum loss of time, then you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968 4264 81. So friends, let me also tell you that if you want to subscribe to them in a complete package format, then the total amounts to 950. But for the students who are subscribing to it in a complete package, we are offering those people a discount of rupees 150. So the complete package to those people are available in 800. So if you want to subscribe to this initiative, then you can WhatsApp us at this given number. So already I have repeated the number again time and again, so you can see it again. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you liked my video, please like it, please share it with your friends, and please suggest. If you have any suggestion for me, I will certainly consider it. And friends, please subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications of the updates that we do on YouTube for the UPSC CSE 2019. So thank you, friends. Thank you very much.